Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fine. So students, today we will start new chapter of our English reader book, that is chapter number 4, The Royal Bengal Tiger. Students, before starting this chapter, I have few questions for you. Have you heard of dinosaurs? Why can't we see them today? Name some animals or birds that will soon vanish from the earth. Why do you think animals and birds vanish? I hope you all have heard about dinosaurs. So why can't we see them today? Because they all have extinct. And there are some birds like dodo birds, and there are some animals, mammals, which will soon vanish from the earth. And why do you think animals and birds vanish? Because of some natural calamities also, as well as because of some human factors also. Humans are also responsible for their extinction. Now this chapter will tell us about Royal Bengal Tiger. So now let us start. Tiger was chosen as the national animal of India due to its grace, strength, quick movement and enormous power. So why it is chosen as the national animal? Because of the strength, because of its grace, as well as the huge power this animal has. That is why this animal is chosen as the national animal of India. As the tiger is also considered a mighty animal of jungle. Mighty means fearless, powerful animal of the jungle. It was an obvious choice for the national animal category. Tigers has always been considered as a royal animal. So tiger has always been considered as a royal animal. The tiger as the national animal of India symbolizes the power, strength, elegance, alertness, intelligence and tolerance of the nation. Now all these qualities of tiger, it represents the nation, our country. However, what is alarming is that there has been a steep fall in the population of tigers in the world, not only in India. Now what is alarming, what is disturbing, what is the reason of worrying is that the steep fall, high fall in the population of tigers. The population of tigers are decreasing day by day in the world. Why they are decreasing? Due to illegal smuggling. Smuggling means moving or taking out the tiger's skin for some other purposes. Due to illegal smuggling of tiger skin and other body parts, there are very few tigers left in the world today. There are only 5,000 to 7,000 tigers in the world today. Only 5,000 to 7,000 in the entire world, out of which Bangladesh, Nepal, Bhutan, China and Myanmar claim to have a population of 3,000 to 4,500. And India alone claims to have a population of 2,500 to 3,750 tigers in India. In India, out of the 8 known types of tigers, the Royal Bengal tiger is found throughout the country except in the northwestern region. So it is found in the entire country except the northwestern region. The north and the west region of the country, except those areas, it is found everywhere in the country. As there was a fear that tigers might be wiped out. Wiped out means they will be finished, they will be vanished from the Indian soil. The Indian government launched the Project Tiger in the year 1973. Since 1973, we are preserving a national animal. So, because the government has the fear that the tigers will soon vanish from the Indian soil, and it is the tiger is the national animal of India, so government launched a Project Tiger in India in the year 1973. The Project Tiger focuses on preserving the remaining tiger population in the country as well as increasing the population of the tigers. The main focus was not only to preserve the tiger population but also to increase the population of the tigers. Under this project, 23 tiger reserves were established throughout the country. So how under this project, how many tiger reserves were established? 23 tiger reserves were established throughout the country, which provides safe and comfortable shelter to the tigers in the natural environment. Now, what are the tiger reserve? Tiger reserve means the place which is being given to the tigers, and like a home where they were given shelter, comfortable shelters, and they were provided safety also in their natural environment. By 1993, there was much improvement in the tiger population in the country. So as a result, in 1993, there is an improvement in the tiger population in the country. However, despite the increase in the population of tigers in the country is still not satisfactory as compared to the efforts and money put in the project. Now, as the population is increasing, has shown the improvement, but still it is not up to the mark. It is not according to the money and efforts put in the project. So this is due to why it is not there. This is the main reason of not it's the main reason of this is that due to illegal poaching of the tiger and the negligence of authorities towards the alarming situation of tiger population in India. So what is the main reason? Illegal poaching. Illegal poaching means illegal hunting of the tigers and negligence, failure of the authorities. Authorities here represents government authorities who were not that much aware of the illegal poaching, and they have not taken the stringent action steps to preserve these tigers. However, the latest estimate shows that 2,226 tigers roamed through the forest reserves in the country in 2014. This shows an increase in the numbers of the national animal of India. With this, India has around 70% of the world's around 3,000 tigers. So 70% of the world's 3,000 tigers were in India in the year 2014. The efforts for the protection of tigers are slowly showing results. Now, despite this illegal poaching, the efforts of the governments are showing results also. In the coming years, the population of the tigers will hopefully increase due to the efforts of the government and the people of our country. Not only the efforts of the government, but also the people of the country. They are also putting efforts, and you can also put efforts in preserving our national animal. Now, you will find out the ways. It is your homework to find out the ways to preserve our national animal. Okay, students, in next video, I will explain you the question answers and the book exercise of this chapter. So I hope you have understood this chapter, and see you soon. Thank you so much, students.